Morning everyone, my name is Agnese Sbrollini, I'm postdoc of Università Politecnica delle Marche. With me there is also Dr. Ilaria Marcantoni, that is also a postdoc here in the Università Politecnica delle Marche. And
Good morning.
together we will present you our master's degree in biomedical engineering. This course is a master's degree, and it is a master's degree in engineering. Thus, we are over the area, the scientific and technological area. This, as you can imagine, I am talking in English. Thus, as you can imagine, this is an English course. In fact, this is the main characteristic of our master's degree. This course has a strong international character. In fact, the courses present in the degree are held in English by both Italian and foreign professors. Usually, our professors are very active in the research as well teaching. Thus, during their course, they will introduce you also in innovative research topic where they are involved. Moreover, we have to say that our courses are followed by also foreign students that are usually the 50% of our classes. These two features, thus the presence of foreign professors and the presence of foreign students, give to the course a strong international character, and it is very important in the work of a biomedical engineer because this topic, this branch of the engineering, is very new. Is innovative, and we are strongly involved in international project and international activity. That is very important for a biomedical engineer to breathe an international spirit, an international environment. In fact, the aim of our course is first of all to prepare the students for their future, for their professional activity. And how do we do it? Specifically, we start from the basic knowledge that the student has acquired during the bachelor degree in biomedical engineering, and we integrate this knowledge with advanced and specialized knowledge, considering both traditional and innovative biomedical sectors. In fact, you will have the standard, the traditional part of bioengineering, such as the mathematical modeling, the signal and image processing, and so on, but also new and innovative part of the biomedical sector, like the new biomaterials, or the use of artificial intelligence to support the medical diagnosis. All these new aspects are integrated with this international feeling that give to the student a transversal knowledge in all the aspects of biomedical engineering. Where will you work? In order to prepare a strong and prepared biomedical engineering, we have to start to where will you work? Which are the area in where you will be involved after your degree, no? Your master's degree. Usually, the biomedical engineering are employed in three main areas of working area. The first of all is, of course, the companies. Thus, the companies that produce technology for medicine or as product specialists. Thus, you may be involved in these two main parts of the company, or in the research and the design, or in the marketing or the product specialist area. The second area is, of course, the hospital, something relative new. Usually, the biomedical engineer inside the hospital becomes a clinical engineer. Thus, an engineer that is called to organize and manage the technologies inside the hospital. This is a very strange, this particular work, because the biomedical engineer is called to organize the technology, the entire pack of technology inside the hospital, and it's called to have a responsibility about this technology. The third, the last but not the least, is the presence of bioengineers inside the research centers, such as the university or other centers that are active in research. In these centers, the biomedical engineers are called to do research, to provide innovation, to discover new technology or new way to use the technology in order to support the innovation. There is also a fourth area in which a biomedical engineer may be involved, that is the idea to open a new startup, that's to open a new company, and this is something that is not so rare, because the innovation, the new character of this biomedical engineer usually give is a field in which new ideas will grow. Does or may grow. Does sometimes our student or our ex-student decided to open company and does to provide work. And this is something very, very fascinating, because you will be who will create work. What will you study in order to support the future work that you will be called to do? These are the course that this course is recent, as the Master degree in biomedical engineering was born in 2015. Thus, in the recent years, it will be changed in order to support the working area. Thus, what the company asks to us. And with this idea, this strong focus to be prepared for the work. That you will be called to do. The Council for the Biomedical Engineering course decided to restructure the courses in two main curricula. That has the curricula of e-health and clinical engineering, and the curriculum of engineering of medical devices. These two curriculum are part of the same degree. It means that at the end of both curricula, the students will take the degree in biomedical engineering. That is exactly the same. But considering that the biomedical engineering has this strong trasversal character, thus it means that biomedical engineer can be focused in different area of this topic. We decided to create these two big curricula, and a student may select the curriculum that he or she like more, and focus on what she likes more. This first part, as you can see, there are these seven courses that are in common in both curricula. And this is because these seven courses are more or less the basis of biomedical engineering. In fact, you will see models and control of biological systems, biomedical signal and image processing, cognitive computation in physiology and medicine, biofluid dynamics, bioimaging, embryo research, bioengineering of motor rehabilitation and applied measurement of techniques. As you can imagine from the titles, you can see that these courses give important basis, as I said during the first slides, traditional and innovative, but they are important for both curriculum. While we have also these last three courses that are not mandatory, thus you may select these courses as you want, but these three courses may be selected from both curricula. While these courses that are in the middle are specifically designed or for the curriculum A or for the curriculum B. In fact, we have that in the curriculum of e-health and clinical engineering, the mandatory courses of this curriculum are bioinformatics and system biology and clinical engineering. Why? Because in the curriculum of e-health and clinical engineering, the knowledge for this type of biomedical engineer are more focused on the area of the e-health, thus the part of informatics and electronic engineering. Moreover, we have we need also some basis of management, because and thus this knowledge will be given by the course of clinical engineering, because this course has also the aim to support the bioengineers that would like to apply for work inside the hospital, thus to manage all the instrumentation inside the hospital. While in the curriculum B, thus in the curriculum of engineering of medical devices, the mandatory courses are biomaterials for medical devices and prosthesis and dynamical modeling of movement. As for the courses of the curriculum A, also this curriculum B are specifically designed for the development and the design of devices in the area of medical devices. For these two curriculum, we have also these not mandatory courses, and as I said, for the courses that may be selected for both curricula, these courses, on the other hand, these courses may be selected, these for the curriculum A and these for the curriculum B. Of course, this is also the possibility for a student that selects one of the two curriculum to select one course of the other curricula, but this choice does. If I am in the curriculum A, but I would like to apply to follow a course of the curriculum B, I can do it, but I have to ask the permission to the council of the degree. Thus, it is possible with a specific bureaucratic procedure. How will you study? This course, as you may imagine after the presentation of the courses, has been designed in order to support the student during their future work. Thus, for this idea, this master degree has to be the bridge between the study activity that you mainly did during the bachelor degree and the future work, in which you will be called to put your hand inside the devices, inside the hospital, inside your work. To do that, of course, we have a part during the courses, you have, of course, frontal lectures from our professor, but an important part of the courses will be focused on lab activities, thus activities inside our laboratories, but also in for project design and project presentation. In order to support this practical part, thus these practical activities, we have during all the degree 12 labs for the students. It means that during the courses, but also during the thesis and the traineeship, you will come in our lab and you will work with us in our research topics. We have to say a few words about the traineeship. This course is a master's degree. It means that the practical part that you will do during the traineeship to prepare your thesis has a large number of hours. In fact, during the bachelor degree, the number of hours for the traineeship is 150, while during the master degree, the number of hours for the traineeship of a master course is 512. It means that during your traineeship, you will have a project, you have to design it, and you have to finalize it, because the traineeship is more or less 3-4 months long. This fact, does the fact that you have a lot of power for your traineeship, is also good to support the possibility to do international experience in our university. And this is strongly encouraged during the master's degree also, because we say that our courses is in English and has this strong international character. Thus, all our professors encourage the traveling of students in the other countries and in other university. And how we do it? We do it having collaborations with other university, having projects together with other university, and it means that you will be part, if you want, you will be part of this project, and you will you may design and bother on this project, not here but in other university with which we daily collaborates. And the fact that all the courses are in English will support you also in be prepared in international activity and international experience such as Erasmus or Campus World. Thus, the practical part is supported by both internal labs in our university, but also by foreign labs with foreign group with which we as professors collaborate. Well, a few words about the numbers, about our performance. We have to say that the 88% of students gave a positive opinion of our master course. And the 94% of students appreciates the professor's availability. This is a very important point because our courses as several students, maybe this year we have a class of 60 students, thus we have a good number. But the number is not so huge. What it means? It means that you are the students are a lot, but not so much that the fact don't permit us to bring you in the lab to organize a trip, for example, does a scholar trip during the courses, but also to have a relationship with us, with the student and with the assistant of the professor, because the number is not so huge. It means that there is this good relation between the student and the professor, and it means that the projects, the theses, and so on are created together with the students, instead of giving a student a task and observing the results of this task during the exam. This is something that usually grow together, is something that the professor and the student create together. About the employment rate, we have the 84% at 1 year from the degree and 100% at 3 years from the degree. And about the satisfaction, it is 7 out of 10, the satisfaction with the work that a student do. And these numbers are higher than the other courses in our university, but also higher than the average score in Italy. Our strength, as I just said, the first strength is, of course, the relationship between the teacher and the student, as I just said. Then we have this strong practical part and the viability of a large number of laboratories in which you may work. There is also the third strength, that is the possibility to work on research projects of excellence. In fact, as I said, our teacher, especially the foreign professor, are very active in the project of excellence. It means that usually when a professor is involved in strong research project, usually he or she bring their expertise in the class. Thus, it means that sometimes your projects or your thesis are involved, are part of this strong project, and thus they may be presented also for publication or for conference participation. And of course, you will be involved in these publications. The fourth strength is, of course, the internationalization, as I say, and also the possibility to open spin-off or startup, because the biomedical engineer is a branch in which that is growing, that is open to innovation and technology. And as we saw during the COVID period, during the pandemia, it is very important to support the medicine in different aspects of their life. Thus, a biomedical engineer is becoming a very important stakeholder in the medicine and the study of physiology. Here are some experiences of our ex-students. As I said, these are the three main areas in which you will be involved. Here we have people that work in hospitals as a researcher, or here as these two as a researcher, these two as clinical engineers. Here we have the research centers. Specifically, we have these three students that nowadays are involved in the PhD programs, especially these two finished their PhD, thus they are postdoc in a moment. And at the end, we have these three students ex-students that are involved in companies, and specific he is involved in as a product specialist, and he work with surgeons for the implantation, for the catheterization and ablation of atrial fibrillation. As you can see, our students are involved in different works, and the biomedical engineer course, our biomedical engineering course, give to different students the support for the different, completely different activity that they like. Does the same course for different careers. At the end, some information about the enrollment. You can easily apply to our master's degree if you did one of these bachelor degree. If you follow other bachelor degree, you will have credits in these different scientific sectors. For the foreign students that would like to apply, their curriculum will be evaluated by our committee. Thus, for each foreign student, the curriculum will be individually evaluated. One important thing is that to be enrolled in this master course, the student may have an English language level equal to B2. I close here this presentation. I am open for your question. I conclude saying that for any information, you may visit the website orienta.univpm.it, but you can also write to me, Agnese Sbrullini, or to Dr. Ilaria Marcantoni, but also to our president, to the president of our course, that is Laura Burattini, and we will be happy to answer to your question, to support you in your decision, and also to have a meeting with you if you would like to deepen, to have more information about the biomedical engineering course. Thank you very much for your listening, for your attention, and I hope to see you in our class next year.